Stephen.
We do.
Do you know that all the dark won't stop the light from getting through?
We do.
Do you wish that you could see it all made new? Is all creation groaning?
It is.
Is a new creation coming?
It is.
And is the glory of the Lord to be the light within our midst?
It is.
And is it good that we remind ourselves of this? Is anyone whole? Is anyone able to break the seal and open the scroll? The Lion of Judah, who conquered the grave. He is David's root and the Lamb who died to ransom the slave. Is he worthy? Is he worthy of our blessing? Is he worthy of this? Yes. Does the Father truly love us?
He does.
Does the Spirit move among us?
He does.
And is Jesus our Messiah? Hold forever those he loves. Does our God intend to dwell again with us? He does. Is anyone worthy? Is anyone whole? Is anyone able to break the seal and open the scroll? The Lion of Judah, who conquered the grave. He is David's root and the Lamb who died to ransom the slave. From every people and tribe, every nation and tongue, he has made us a kingdom and priest to God to reign with the Son. Is he worthy? Is he worthy of our blessing and honor and glory? Is he worthy? Is he worthy? Is he worthy of this? He is. God, we just are overwhelmed by your word and your promises to us. And I'm just reminded in this song we just sang through that is just what your scripture says, that we can hope in you. You have conquered. And all the tears and all the hurt and all the pain in this world, you are not going to let that go. You're going to come back and you're going to make things right. And we're so thankful that the only one who is worthy is Jesus. And he made a way.
We're so grateful. In your name, amen. You guys be seated. Amen.
Thank you, guys. Before we continue on this morning, I want to say a couple of things. And first of all, I want to say about Mark, who has been with us a bunch of times now. I always appreciate Mark when he leads us. He said something in the very beginning about leading us to the throne, leading us in worship to the throne. And that is what it's all about when we come together on Sunday morning and worship. And Mark is, to me, always particularly sensitive to that. That seems like that's his goal, is to lead us into God's presence and worship. And I appreciate that every single time. And I especially appreciate what Mark, the theme of our worship this morning, which was God's faithfulness and God's promises to us. And I especially, do you notice how many times I've said especially now? I especially loved the song, which I didn't know, new song, and the line that said, all of his promises are yes and amen. Amen. Now that means something to me. I don't know if it means something to you, but let me tell you, it means something to us as a church this morning, because as we get ready to kick off Vacation Bible School, this is going to be the single most important evangelistic outreach that we have for the entire year. Is going to take place over the next 6 days or 5 days. And I'm telling you, it is important. And this morning's service, the rest of our service, as we focus towards starting VBS tonight, is all about God's promises, and it's about our prayers to Him, asking Him to bless everything that's going to take place in VBS. And so all His promises are yes and amen. That should mean something to us as a church. Now, we're going to do a couple of things this morning. We're going to do some things that are different than what we normally do. So if you're a guest this morning, just know this isn't our normal way of doing service, but it's special today. We're going to have a children's message. We're going to invite all of our kids to come forward in just a moment. And our children's pastor, Jimmy Hall, is going to come and lead us in a children's message. We're going to have some opportunities to see some video that kind of give us an idea of what VBS is all about, the priority of it, the theme of it. And then we're going to have an opportunity as a church to pray together and to commit to pray, not only this morning, asking a blessing over VBS, but we are going to have an opportunity to commit to pray over these next few days. And I hope that you would allow your hearts, hopefully already, to be led into God's presence, but I hope that you would open your heart to what God wants to say to us this morning so that we can make commitments in prayer. Let's begin with our children's pastor, Jimmy Hall. As he comes, we're going to invite all of our kids, everybody who's going to be involved in VBS, for them to come down to the front right here, and let's welcome Jimmy, our children's pastor, and let's come on. Now, I may be stealing a little bit of Jimmy's thunder here, but we have more than at least 70 kids registered for VBS tonight.
Damn right. Damn.
So this is just this is like the cream of the crop right here as they tear down the signs, and this is the cream of the crop. Okay, they're facing the wrong direction. You guys turn around this way if you would.
Right here.
All right, Jimmy. It's all yours. Take it.
Thanks. Okay, everybody, stand up and turn around and wave to your parents, okay? Say hi. Yeah, wave to them. All right, we can sit back down. You know, that all these people can be pretty scary, can't they? Yeah, that's why we're over in the other building, because it's too scary over here. And I guarantee you, your parents, just from this first 10 minutes, they're scared that we're going to stop live worship and that you'd be over here the whole time. But we won't. Okay. What do you think of all these animals up here? It's pretty cool, huh? Yeah. Y'all have any of these animals as pets at home? You do? Which one?
Every single one.
You have? Thank you. All right. Mr. Nichols, I didn't know you had that many pets at home. Have you ever seen an elephant in church before?
No.
No, doesn't happen very often, does it? Do you know why they're here?
No.
Because we start VBS tonight. And this year's theme is In the Wild. So that's why I'm dressed like this. That's why we have a waterfall and wild animals. And anytime you get to see one of these animals, either out in the wild or at the zoo, it's a pretty amazing encounter, isn't it? And do you know who made all these animals up here?
God
did. That's exactly right. Who made us? That's right. God made us. And do you know why he made us? So we can have an amazing encounter with Jesus. You know, he loves you so much that he wants to have an amazing encounter with you. And then he wants you to live forever and ever with him in heaven. Isn't that cool? Man, can you imagine him loving us that much? This week, we've got 5 days of amazing encounters with Jesus, and all these animals are going to be here this whole week. You should see your classrooms over there. It's jungle, there's vines and monkeys, it looks so great. Everybody went such a hard time. But tonight, we start. And our first encounter with Jesus is we see him in Jerusalem. And he's all by himself. He and his parents and a big group of people had gone to Jerusalem to celebrate a feast. And it got time to go. Everybody gathered up, his parents and all their relatives, and they took off. And they traveled a whole day. And that evening, Mary said, "Joseph, I haven't seen Jesus all day." And they started looking for him, and he wasn't there. And so they had to turn around. They went back to Jerusalem, and they looked for him for 3 days. He was 12 years old, and he was in Jerusalem all by himself. They finally found him, and he was at the temple, and he was talking about God. So that's going to be really, really neat when we see him tonight. Tomorrow night, we get to see Jesus at a river. Don't you just love rivers? Oh, man, I love rivers. I love walking up and down the shoreline, exploring. But when we see Jesus, he's there with John, and he's getting baptized. And what is the neatest thing, the coolest thing ever, is that after he was baptized, and we talked about this within the last couple of weeks over in live worship, that when he came up out of the water, God spoke out loud from heaven. And he confirmed that Jesus was his son. Now, you know what? That is the only time in the Bible that we see God speaking out loud to where people could understand him. I wonder what his voice sounded like. Do you think it was, "This is my beloved son"? Or do you think it was, "This is my beloved son"? Yeah, I don't think so. I think he sounded like God. But we're going to ask him when we get to heaven one day. And so that's going to be such a neat night too. Then the next night, we see Jesus on the lake. Don't y'all love the lake? Oh, man. You know, you get a swim and tube and ski, right? But to do all those things, you got to have a boat, don't you? Got to have a boat to be out on the lake. Well, when we see Jesus, he's on the lake, out in the middle of the lake, but he's not swimming and he's not in a boat. He's walking on the water. Can you imagine walking on the water? I wonder what it was like. Is it like a sponge or is it like glass? One day we'll have to find out. That is going to be, I cannot wait for that night. Wednesday night is also going to be something special. Because you know what we get to go do? Go see him in a graveyard. That can be scary, right, Chandler?
No.
No? That's right. Not when we see Jesus. We see Jesus. He's crucified on the cross, and he dies, and they bury him. But you know what is really, really cool? Does he stay buried? No, he doesn't, does he? That's right. God brought him back to life to prove that he's God's son and that he could conquer death. And you know what? He is still alive today. That's why we didn't have an amazing encounter with him, because he is still alive. Thursday, the last night, we're going to meet Jesus on the road. Now on the road. How could you have an amazing encounter on the road? I mean, roads can take you places, right? Yeah. When we see Jesus on the road, he's talking to two men, and he explains to them that everything in the Bible, every story, every verse, every word points to him. God knew it was so important that we understand who Jesus is, that he's God's son, that he came to die for our sins, that he came to have an amazing encounter with us. And so that's why he gave us the Bible. Everything in there points to Jesus. And that by our relationship with him, that's the only way we can get to heaven. So this week is going to be wild. We are going to get after it. There's going to be games, food, prizes, fun. Yeah, it's going to be great. So I want you all to invite your friends. You get a prize, you bring a friend, you get a prize. We're going to have a treasure chest. It is just going to be very cool. So will you all come there tonight and bring your friends? Great. All right. We will see you tonight. Oh, now, stand up. Turn around. Look for your parents, even if they're hiding from you. And you can go back to your parents. Okay, guys?
Very good. We're going to show the VBS promotion clip, just a couple of minutes long. We want to show you about the theme of VBS this year, In the Wild. Here we go. So as you can tell, it's going to be exciting. You guys have already seen some of the decorations around the worship center. Didn't they do a great job on that, getting prepared for VBS? Yeah, pretty cool. How many of you had to duck when you came in at some point tonight? How many of you wondered if you'd make it across the bridge when you came in this morning? Okay, all right, very good. Now, what we're going to do as we kind of finish out the service this morning, we want to offer up several specific prayers. And we're going to begin with Wade Deaver. Wade's going to come, and we're going to ask Wade to pray specifically just for our VBS, just for the whole week and everything that's going to take place. And then as Wade prays, and when he finishes, then I'm going to ask you to make a commitment. And after each of these prayers, I'm going to ask you if you will commit to pray for this thing that has been prayed for. But I want you to commit to pray for the rest of the week, each night, five nights, as we work through VBS. So, Wade, if you will come, and Wade is going to pray for our VBS program tonight.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, please bless this church and all those involved in VBS this week. Help our leaders and teachers show love to our children. Please help our church to have guidance, patience, and knowledge to teach your word. God, help our children to be attentive and curious so they can further their understanding of what it means to be a Christian. And also let us remember Proverbs 22:6. Start children off on the way they should go, and even when they are old, they will not turn from it. In your name we pray. Amen.
And will you commit as a church to pray for these things over the next five nights? If you will, say amen. Amen. We're going to show you another video this morning. This is actually a short video clip from last year, 2018's VBS. And just give you an idea of all the crazy stuff that's happening and taking place with our kids during the VBS week. Let's watch this video together. Almost forgot how traumatic last year was, but hopefully this year not as traumatic. All right, we're going to ask Jim Dunlap if he will come, and Jim is going to pray specifically for unchurched kids that will be a part of our Vacation Bible School this year. And as I mentioned, this is a huge outreach for us as a church and for our community. We want to ask you, please invite your children, your grandchildren, your neighbors, your friends to come and be a part of VBS this week. So many people, their first experience with Jesus is at Vacation Bible School. Jim, will you pray for all these kids?
And Justin hates handing me the microphone every time. I didn't know part of Jimmy Hull being our children's minister, we had to put his picture up
all over the church
for Vacation Bible School. You know, it's interesting. I do want to say one personal thing. I don't know if Pam and I would be here at this Oakdale Baptist Church without VBS and our children when we moved here 15 years ago. So as we look, and my mom always said to me, missions begins at home. And there's people up and down Hefner and up and down Sooner Road that need and want to be part of this church. And I just hope that we can remember that this week. And would you pray with me over that? Heavenly Father, we come to you with a wonderful feeling this week that we start tonight the great efforts of Vacation Bible School that so many of us did when we were young, and we led our children through, and our children led us through. That as we talk about the children in this community, that we mission to them, that we give the great commission to them, that we go out and talk to them and find them, and that they come here. And that we ask for your guidance, and that that we recognize the opportunities, not only with the children that come through these doors tonight, but also with the parents who come through these doors tonight, who are bringing their children who possibly also need a church home and also need a closer relationship with you. We ask for these great things in this great community of Oakdale Baptist and Oakdale Community and Oakdale School. We want to be part of your solution and part of your glory. And we ask all these things in your Son's holiest of names. Amen.
And if you will agree to commit to praying especially and specifically for our lost and unchurched kids that will come through the doors this week, will you say amen? Amen. Let me invite Paul Kirsch, our associate pastor, is going to come. And Paul is going to pray specifically for all of our VBS participants. I mentioned that we have about 70 kids. We have another 70 adults and teens who are working with our kids. So about 150 kids this week that will be working and experiencing Vacation Bible School. We want to pray for everybody who's participating.
Let's pray. Father, there has been a tremendous amount of work that has gone in to even to this point. And I just pray that you will bless all that effort. Father, for all those that are involved, and there are many, from Jimmy and all his team and all the volunteers and then all the kids that will come and all the parents that will be coming and dropping their kids off, Lord, we just pray that you would do a mighty work in the lives of the people that are here all week long. I pray that you would bring stamina and energy to all the workers. I pray that you would bring all the children here with great attitudes and an obedient heart and ready to hear from you. God, I pray that you would allow any and all that get to speak into the lives of the kids. I pray that we would be able to speak the gospel to them in everything that we do and everything that we say. May it present who you are and what you want to do in their lives. Father, bless this week, maybe like any other week that we'll have. I just pray that you will use it for your glory. It's in your name that we pray. Amen.
And if you'll commit to pray for all participants in Vacation Bible School this week, each night through Thursday night, will you say amen? Amen. I appreciate that. Now, we're going to bring Brian Williams, and he is going to pray specifically for each of our Vacation Bible School workers. And as I mentioned, we have teenagers who will be helping in classes all the way up through adults, and we want to pray for them specifically. And so, Brian, will you come and do that?
Sure. Following a pastor to pray.
You can do it.
Kind of like hitting a 3-iron after Tiger Woods or something. Just like, well, here we go. Loving God, I just come to you today, God, and I'm just so thankful for the teachers and the volunteers who have already put work in for this VBS and God and the work they'll do this week. I pray for their strength, for patience, God. I pray that you will be with them as they bring messages to these young lives, God. And we know that just as Paul said, that we are qualified and qualified because of Jesus, God. And I just pray that you will put that in their mind throughout the week, that they are qualified, and you will just give them the words that you would have them to say. I ask all things in Christ's name. Amen.
All right, we're going to have Mark come now. And here, I'm not going to ask you to commit to this part by voice. I'm going to ask you to commit to praying specifically for our workers with a physical action. And that is that we have prayer bracelets here at the front. This one is for Brianna Nichols. And so I took that one. I'm going to put it on. I'm going to pray for her each night and all day. Each time I see that bracelet, I'm going to think about her, how hard she's been working, the time she spends with her students. And I'm going to do that each day. I'm going to invite you guys to come and to do the same thing. And so in just a moment, I'm going to have you stand, and you are invited to come to the front. And all across the front, we have these bracelets. We want you to come and get one, put it on, and use it as a reminder to pray for them. Also this morning, Paul and I will both be here at the front. If you need someone to pray with you, or if there is a decision that needs to be shared with our church, sometimes we do that. We want to invite you to come and to do that as well. Let's stand together. And as Mark leads us in worship, you guys are now invited and welcome to come and take a bracelet.
And how great the chasm that lay between us, how high the mountain I could not climb. In desperation, I turned to heaven and spoke your name into the night. And through the darkness, your loving kindness tore through the shadows of my soul. The work is finished, the end is written. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Could imagine so great a mercy, what heart could fathom such boundless grace? The God of ages stepped down from glory to wear my sin and bear my shame. The cross has broken, I am forgiven. The King of Kings calls me his own. Beautiful Savior, I'm yours forever. Jesus Christ, my living.
I just want to invite you, as we finish up this part of our service, if you're a guest with us this morning, if you are not a church member but maybe a regular attender, maybe there's a thought in your mind, this isn't for me, but that's not the case. If you're here today, you're invited to be a part of prayer specifically for our workers this week. So I'm going to ask Mark just to continue on for a few minutes more. And if you would like to come and take a prayer bracelet, you're welcome to come and do that. Also, if you'd like to get one for someone else in your family that's not here, you're welcome to do that as well. Hope you guys will take those bracelets and use them this week to be in prayer. And just think of all the things God can accomplish as we join Him in prayer for VBS.
Well, amen. I think you can see we've got a great week planned and some great opportunities that God's put in front of us. Amen. I'm going to ask you to stand, and we're going to dismiss after we pray. One quick announcement, remind you that next Sunday, we'll be back to our normal schedule with community groups and those kind of things, and so make sure that you're aware of that, and be in prayer all this week, if you would. You've got those prayer bands now. Use that and pray for all this week as we are expecting God to do some great things. And if we expect him to do some of those things and we submit to him, he's going to do some great things. And so we want to do that this week. Let's pray together and we'll be dismissed. Father, thank you again for this time. Pray that you would bless all our efforts this week. Pray for each child that comes that you will speak to their heart even before they begin to walk through these doors. We just pray that you are doing something amazing in our midst. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.